Bonga of Showbiz Bonga. Hi, Clan!
Hello po!
Hi, Darren.
Hello po.
Good evening. Congratulations. Darren, I was there nung MOA Arena na May 29, 2015.
Yes, opo.
The birthday concert, di ba? Oh, kung saan na you made history being the youngest artist na mag-perform sa MOA. Oh, 14 years old ka pa noon, and now 10th year mo na sa showbiz. How tapos dito ulit sa big venue ulit sa Araneta. How different yung ano, yung kamusta yung feeling yung back then and now, yung kaba, yung excitement, how is it?
Ako po, walang naiba talaga eh sa kaba. Parang it's always something that's there. Kahit sa mga smaller venues or events, yung parang basta kakanta ako or magpo-perform, kinakabahan po talaga ako, nakakaba talaga. And of course, this time I'm staging a concert at the Araneta Coliseum, which for me is really a big deal. There's that certain pressure po talaga, but at the end of the day, it's all about enjoying the experience, being present. Ano ba yan? May langaw.
Sumama yata sa showtime.
yung drone ng showtime nakaabot dito. Ayun po. Pero yun nga, it's all about being present in the moment, enjoying the experience and of just performing at the big dome. And ayun nga po, excited ako kasi we've created this lineup months ago pa po. Talagang we've started preparing months ago. And I'm just lucky enough to have the venue on June 1 din, which is really something that I asked ABS for. Yung para kung sana po masecure talaga yung June 1 kasi yun yung mismong araw ng aking 10th anniversary. So, na-secure po siya. I'm just really happy that it's finally happening and we're down to the last 3 weeks before the show po. Yeah.
And then for my last question, Darren, just to clear the air lang, yung pwede manghingi ng statement saka reaction from you. Siyempre kasi diba alam natin nagkaroon na issue dun sa poster. Ano yung reaction mo doon?
Kami po ng team ko sa ABS-CBN and Star Music, we had the artist line up based on how we announced the guests. And lahat naman po ng pictures na nasa poster ko ay galing sa artists mismo, from their managements mismo. Yun nga, nagulat yung Popstars kasi unreleased picture pa ni Ate Sara yung nakagamit sa poster. So, ayun po. Like, everything went under approval of everyone's management. So, no one was bothered by the poster originally and stuff like that. But we also opted to just kind of take the initiative to kind of put a different format on the poster. So,
yung billing din kasi ang naging issue, Darren. Yung billing, yung pagkakasunod ng mga pictures.
Yun po eh. The billing for us was pre-approved nga po by everyone's management. And it was in the order that the guests were also announced. So, sa amin internally, wala talagang issue dun. Yun po. Yeah.
Magkakaroon ka ba ang collab sa kanila during the concert? May performance get together with any of the guests?
All of them po.
Ah,
yes. Yun po, all of the guests. So exciting, yun yung dapat yung abangan kung anong gagawin.
Thank you, Darren. Congratulations.
Yes. Salamat po.
Thank you so much, Sir Glenn. Now we have MJ Marfori of TV5. Is MJ here? Okay, so I will be asking the questions for MJ. So, Darren, what kind of performance are you going to give the audience given the new technology that comes into play in today's concert scene? Was there any particular show that gave you inspiration and that you would want to level it up as you perform your songs for the audience?
Ito pong stage ko sa D10 is a lot different from my past concerts in terms of stage design and also the technology nga po, which was mentioned in the question. Kasi like half of my team right now isn't here kasi andun sila sa meeting with our creative directors and also sa stage managers and stuff like that in terms of technical stuff. So, I'm excited kasi meron mga ilaw sa concert ko. Ano ba tawag dito? There's lights in my concert that are gonna be used for the first time in the Philippines. So, magugulat na lang kayo, akala nyo parang andun lang stagnant lang siya, tapos bigla siyang gagalaw-galaw. Like, it, tinatransform niya yung stage per number. So, parang hindi lang siya nandyan the whole time. So, that's what's crazy about the technology now. Kasi parang every year there's something new na iniimbento. May bagong ways to deliver visuals, to be able to stage a concert po talaga eh. So, I'm really excited. So, isa yun sa mga kailangan po nilang abangan. Opo.
Very exciting, especially for the 10-year anniversary. Dapat may pasabog talaga, especially
yes.
with the lights then. So, the first oh. time in the Philippines.
Di tayo papahuli.
Wow. Oh. Competitive. I love it. Okay, now our next questions are coming from G. Trilliana. I will also be reading out their questions. So, G asks, in your 10 years in the business, you've become friends with a lot of celebrities. Can you please mention 5 showbiz friends and what you have learned from them or what they have taught you? Nako.
5 showbiz friends.
In no particular order.
Oo, para ayoko naman silang tawaging... Tawaging? Ayoko silang... Ito na naman si Bulol. Ayoko naman silang tawaging showbiz friends, boy. Kasi they've become friends in my personal life outside of showbiz. So, ayan, like first of all, si Ate Sara Jeronimo, one of the people I've met early on in my career. Syempre siya po yung naging coach ko sa The Voice Kids. She always told me to sing from the heart. And it might sound simple po talaga eh. Pero nung bata ako, kanta lang ako ng kanta. Medyo walang emotion masyado. Kasi wala pa naman akong mga personal experiences. I didn't really know how to deliver that kind of emotion. But when I learned to sing from the heart, when I got older, it really made such a big difference in my performances. Tsaka, napapansin din po ng ibang tao. So, that's one of the tips that I've gotten from Ate Sara. Sing from the heart. It can be such a simple song, with such a simple message, pero as long as galing sa puso yung pagkanta mo, sabi niya, tatagos yun sa mga tao. So, ayan po isa sa mga tips na natutunan ko from one of my friends in showbiz. Another one would be from Kuya Eric also. Kasi sa ASAP natin to, lalo na nung pandemic, kami-kami lang talaga yung magkakasama. There were no glam teams. Bawas yung tao sa production. So, kaming artists, mas may time po kami magkausap-usap since we started doing taping cycles. And then, si Kuya Eric, sabi niya mag-release ka lang na mag-release ng mga kanta kasi that's what we're here for eh. It's something that you also dreamt of doing now that you have the opportunity ngayon mo pa ba. Alam mo yun, babawasan yung ginagawa mong mga kanta. And ako po, parang syempre yung mindset ko minsan, sana mag-hit. And later on I realized na it's not about, you know, always having a hit single. It's about what you release, the quality of the single that you are offering to the people. And malay mo, isa sa mga singles na yun mag-hit eh. Kaya I'm really inspired by my coach Ate Sara, sina Kuya Eric. They just keep on releasing singles. Like this year, ang dami na nilang na-release, which is something inspiring to myself, like the younger generation as well, to just keep on writing songs, keep on releasing songs as well. And then another tip from Mama Rich naman was to just keep on singing. Parang weird siya pakinggan, just keep on singing. Pero totoo, yung parang minsan kasi tinatanong niya, bakit hindi ka mag-concert? Bakit hindi ka mag-show dito sa ganito, ganyan? Yung parang isa ka sa mga artistang dapat laging nagko-concert. Sabi ko, Mama Rich, parang nakaka-pressure naman po kung lagi akong nagko-concert. Sabi niya, hindi, napipressure ka ba dahil gusto mong mapuno lagi yung mga venue? Kailangan ba malaki lagi? Sabi niya, ako nga, pumupunta ako sa mga bars. Like, nagpa-bar tour ako. I do smaller shows kasi gusto ko lang kumanta. Sabi niya, and that's also a way to market yourself. Not just to those who wanna watch shows in big venues, but also to people who are just chilling in bars. You know, that's also a way to reach that kind of audience. So that's another tip that I learned from Mama Reg. Ang dami ko talagang natutunan sa ASAP Cycles during the pandemic. And then also from Tito Martin Rivera. Ang dami nila talaga, promise. Yung si Tito Martin naman, he gave me tips on longevity. Kasi may times na parang yun nga, we would open, my mom and I would be able to talk with him kasi si mommy sumasama sa akin sa mga tours abroad. So minsan kapag ASAP nakakausap namin si Tito Martin pag abroad. And then there are times where we open up na parang I don't know how long I'm gonna be able to last in this industry. I wonder where this will take me. And sabi niya, no, just keep on doing what you do as long as it's your passion at the end of the day and you follow what your parents say, which is to always stay humble. Malayo yung mararating mo. And parang isa po yun sa mga tumatak sa akin. Kasi I keep on putting this certain pressure on myself to be able to live up to people's expectations. That was me before. And then, yun nga, sabi ni Tito Martin, like, just keep doing what you love. Hayaan mo kung anong isipin nila. Like, don't care about what other people say as long as you're enjoying what you're doing now. And wala kang tinatapakang mga tao. Yun yung sabi ni Tito Martin. So, ayun. That's one of the things that's also stuck with me. And then with Tito Gary Valenciano, ang dami ko nang natutunan kay Tito Gary in terms of music, personal life, but also, since parang puro personal life na yung mga iba, ito naman si Tito Gary, he's taught me so much in terms of music production. Like, when I visit him at his house, kasi medyo magkalapit lang po bahay namin, we're kind of neighbors. So, I get the chance to see him in his studio, in his element talaga, sobra siyang hands-on sa lahat ng ginagawa niya in terms of music production. Grabe siya mag-produce ng sarili niyang vocals, he mixes his own vocals, he creates his own music. Nakaka-inspire. Sobra talagang hands down. And then, I can't give certain tips on that eh. Parang, he just teaches me. And then I observe. So, I'm grateful kasi not everyone has the opportunity to be mentored by all of these icons po talaga. So, lima yun sa mga tips na nakuha ko from my friends in the industry. Ayun.
Yeah.
Tsaka kung mga friends lang ako, no, mga icons yung binabanggit ko. It's crazy. Yun po talaga. Like, I just can't believe it.
Yeah, that's so true. Like you mentioned a while ago, these are people you just looked up to and now these are people who are your friends.
Crazy.
People you can count on.
Opo.
So, crazy talaga ang life, guys. Yes. I would totally agree. But our next question is coming from Jan Milo Severo. I will also be asking their question. And this one might have a little bit of a spoiler, especially if you haven't seen the ending of Can't Buy Me Love just yet. But they're asking, ano ba yung reaction mo sa ending ng Can't Buy Me Love? Si Bettina ba ang hula mo?
Actually, si Bettina na yung hula ko like a month before the finale. Opo, talaga. Kasi parang walang nang bibintang kay Bettina eh. Lahat Wilson, Cindy, Gina, kay Aya Charleston. Parang kay Mang Ibe, yung mga ganun yung parang hindi eh, masyadong obvious. Yung parang binibigay masyado ng writers namin kung sino, kung sila nga yung killer. So sabi ko, si Bettina, siya yung walang, no one's blaming her for killing Divine eh. So parang, pag tinignan mo, talagang may ano ako eh, kakanood ko to ng mga serial killer, mga documentary sa Netflix eh. Ito nang gawa sa akin ng pandemya, yung pag-binge watch ng mga true-to-life scene of the crime, ano, mga ganun. Si Bettina kasi, bata pa lang siya, may certain hatred na siya towards Divine's family and also kay Ling. Tapos, growing up, walang nasa side niya, she was never heard. At saka wala siyang backstory. Alam mo yun, yung parang lahat sila napakita na yung backstory nila eh. Si Bettina wala talaga. So bakit? Mapapatanong ka bakit wala? Yung batang Irene nga meron, yung batang Caroline meron, batang Charleston meron. So bakit wala yung kay Bettina? Pinakita lang si Jana na ano, parang laging nasa tabi ni Leong Irene but never like anything deep. So that's when I was like, feeling ko si Bettina. Tapos ayun, since naka NDA kami, hindi naman mapag-usapan sa set. Wala, alam mo yung parang, sino tingin mong hula mo? Wala, we're not allowed to talk to each other. Kapag kukunan na yung mga scenes for the finale, walang artistang iba na pwede sa set, kundi yung kukunan, glam team, anyone but the production and the director. Yun lang talaga yung pwede. So wala po kaming idea talaga. Tapos since they all shot alternative endings, lahat sila took turns na sinasaksak si Divine. Hindi kami, lahat kami hindi namin alam kasi parang nung last day na parang oo, sinaksak ko si Divine pero hindi ko alam kung ako yung pumatay kasi sinaksak din nito si Divine. Lahat kami sinaksak si Divine, so yun. At least dapat pala nakipag-bet ako eh. Kung sino yung killer, nanalo sana ako. Yeah.
Grabe, obvious na pinag-isipan talaga ni Dan.
Yes. Tsaka aside from Bettina being the killer, dun sa ending, nakita nyo po, si Stephen, iba na yung naging love interest. Si Jersey na. So, ayun. At least, from Irene to Caroline to Jersey, si Stephen. Oh.
What a whirlwind of emotions.
I know.
Grabe.
Yun talaga yung totoong love triangle.
Grabe talaga. Grabe talaga yung Can't Buy Me Love. So, sorry if you haven't seen the ending.
Oo, okay, na-spoil ko na.
Sorry, spoiler alert. Okay.
Tapos but, na yung ano eh, tapos na yung NDA.
Pwede na.
Oo, pwede na.
Pwede na. But John Milo also asks, you have a lot of improvements na sa acting mo. Tuloy-tuloy na ba ang acting career mo?
Well, if the opportunity comes, tsaka, you know, if my schedule would allow it. Depende po sa project, syempre, of course, I'd love to do more acting in the future. Kasi, feeling ko nga, sabi ko nga, feeling ko naman na ibawi ko yung sarili ko from The House of Us dito kay Stephen Tanueco. Kasi yung The House of Us, as Johan Silva, hindi, wala talaga akong experience in acting, wala akong workshops bago lumipat ng Amsterdam. Eto kay Stephen Tanueco, medyo, ano eh, nakabawi. So, nakuha ko, yun nga eh, sabi ni Donnie, dude, be bothered if hindi mo naapektuhan yung mga viewers. But you did such a great job in portraying Stephen. And I'm proud of you kasi nainis yung tao sa'yo. Good job. Sabi ko, that means a lot. Kasi syempre, coming from the lead. Tsaka sinabi niya yun sa last day of taping namin. So it was something that I took home with me. Yung parang at least na-appreciate ng mismong mga leads yung nagawa ko sa show. Ayun.
That's so true. Naka-evoke ka ng mga emotions from other. Kahit na nainis sila sa'yo.
Well, at gabi, Stephen, something. Nakikita ko sa Twitter, gabi-gabi, daming mga nang babash kay Stephen. Pero, sinasabi nyo, nakainis ka, Stephen. Pero, darin ang galing mo.
Yes, that's the goal.
Opo. Uh-oh. So, maraming salamat po.
At least may divide naman, di ba?
Yes.
They got it. Okay, our next